mainframe is an amazing thing, and to sort of relate it a little bit better to the average person, one thing is everybody thinks they're gigantic. They're not that big. They're extremely capable in terms of having like 141 5 gigahertz processors within the system with, you know, 10 terabytes of memory and 160 high-performance PCIe I/O slots, and that's a very capable system. I mean, they're becoming more energy efficient with each generation. They're becoming more broadly capable with each generation. Security gets better, memory gets better, I/O gets better. It's a constantly evolving environment. So the law of physics that we had to bend to get Z13 was essentially conservation of energy. I personally committed back in the 2008 Z10 timeframe to our clients that I would try very, very hard to keep our systems at the same power level from generation to generation. And we've accomplished that with Z10 to Z196, Z196 to ZEC12, and ZEC12 to Z13. The Z13 was a very transformational system, which was very important to me personally, and like I said, to the IBM Corporation and to Z Systems. We were driving a transformation both in the package, going from what was a book type plugged into a board kind of package to individual drawers that are connected by SMP cables to make one large SMP. That in itself was challenge enough, but then the fact that we were putting so much more capacity into the system, they were adding so much more memory, they were adding all these new capabilities like 2 threads per processor, and we're adding what's called SIMD, single instruction multiple data, and a whole bunch of other performance items, made it clear that it was going to be very valuable to our clients and to Z and to IBM, but to me too.